This is turpentine. It is used as a solvent and also used in varnish to dilute it. It is similar to thinner and is very flammable. As you can see, it burns very vigorously. The cool thing that I found about this is that it easily dissolves thermocol or styrofoam. This is a regular hand sanitizer. It has about 72% alcohol and that is what causes it to ignite. As it is mentioned here, it is flammable and if it is in contact with ice, we must rinse the ice thoroughly. As you can see, it burns with a light blue flame. It is not that dangerous in small amount. It is still very hot. As you can see, it can easily light this paper on fire. This is a sanitizer spray. It has about 74% alcohol. It is flammable since it contains alcohol. Igniting it, we can see that it burns with a blue flame. It can be considered safe in small quantity. This is ethyl alcohol. This is a clear liquid most commonly used to disinfect items, equipments, and also it is the main component used in hand sanitizers. When we ignite it, it burns with a blue flame. As it is in pure form, it burns more clearly than sanitizers. It has about 74% alcohol in it. This is a disinfectant spray. It has about 60% alcohol, which is what makes it flammable. It is mostly used to disinfect sofas, carpets, seats, doorknobs and such items. It has many precautionary measures. I am doing this just as a precautionary measure as the vapors are also very flammable. As the alcohol is not pure, it burns with an orange-yellow flame. This is a common perfume. It has ethyl alcohol in it, which makes it flammable. It has many precautions given here, like if sprayed in ice, rinse with plenty of water. We can see a flame similar to that of alcohol. It burns very vigorously when it is sprayed directly to the flame. This is a room freshener. Here, many precautionary measures are also given, like avoid contact with eyes and skin. I am doing this because the vapors are highly flammable and they can be dangerous in large amount. As we can see, it is highly flammable. With just a small amount, we can create such a huge flame. It also vigorously catches fire when sprayed. This is thinner, which is commonly used as a solvent to dissolve paint. It contains spirit, due to which it is highly flammable and should not be kept close to any flame. This is a very dangerous liquid as it can spontaneously catch fire, and this should never be poured into naked flame. We can see that it catches fire very quickly. This is superglue. This is used to form strong bonds on materials such as metal, ceramic, leather, and many similar surfaces. We can see that it also burns very quickly. This is diesel. This is mostly used in cars and vehicles as a vapor form, as it is very easy to catch fire. You might think that it catches fire very quickly, but rather it is difficult to catch fire. It catches fire once its flash point temperature is reached, which is around 35 to 95 degrees Celsius, and burns very brightly. This is kerosene, which is similar to diesel. This is mostly used in lamps and as heating oil. It is difficult to catch fire. It catches fire once its flash point temperature is reached, which is around 38 degrees Celsius, and burns quite well.